What's happening, y'all? Welcome back to the Elden Ring walkthrough. And let's start things off this episode. The first thing, we're gonna go to some catch-up thing here. So right on table, this guy is your base incarnations merchant. You decide that you wanna dabble, the build up at the face a little bit, and he will, you know, open up the dialogue, and you can pick up the incarnations. Yeah, just until we finish the conversations. Alright. So this guy will leave the part way through the story, so anything that looks interesting for this, you know, pick it up. Go and buy, and you know, since you can make that's for him. Now he has good stuff. Next guy is a D. He has a pretty long quest line. You can get his armor at the end of it, but there's nothing else, you know, to nothing to do with him. Just remember, we made him out. And Dorinia, there's nothing to worry about him. He's gonna join the joint manor. We're also gonna join the manor. Nothing else to worry about him for the time being. He has a lot of things to say. Yeah, so the next one over there, if you interact with him, you should get just right there. Yeah, the emote. And this is where the Gideon, where he will end up be, but he's not there for right now. And nothing here for there right now, but the NPC will show up later time, so yeah, nothing shows up there for now. And this is a twin maiden hugs through the game, and we're gonna find these things called the bell bearings. If you kill the NPC, you'll get the bell bearings, so you can now still get access to items they might have sold. So more importantly, we're gonna find a bell bearing that will allow us to pick up the upgrade mechs. So I will up the base upgrade mechs, the somber mechs. I cannot find the bell bearing anywhere in the game for the final upgrade here, but everything else you can purchase infinite amount of the with the rooms beyond it. There's the two items for the multiplayer items right there. This allows you to jump in and help the summon being invaded. And this one's great if you're playing through that you want to call up if you have this on and active and someone invades you. And this will try to summon a blue to protect you. Beyond that, as you get more souls, I suggest you to picking up the stone sword key. Also, suggest picking the memory stone if you are a caster. And then, you know, she has the rune arc, which we don't really need it for now, but there's a 5 if you want. And beyond that, basically all the star weapons and some of the things are here as well. So just keep in mind. There's the funny that if you're on a host, if you bring a summon, the summon can pretend to be the host, and host can pretend to be the summon. But beyond that, not really worried about it. So go out to over that this way. Yeah, don't go to the maiden yet. We're just gonna go to the blacksmith. Yeah, don't go to her yet. Yeah, ask him about their where's about their Rika. Rodrika. Yes. Let's run through his dialogue. He's gonna say that she has a talent for speed tuning, which is what we want. And go back. We're gonna talk to her. Yeah, just talk to her. Yeah, tell her that the blacksmith sent her. Blacksmith said, go back to blacksmith again. and pick up that same conversation about. Okay, now we have to go back to her. Let me go back to him one last time. Yeah, we don't have to do this, but this is the last time, so we already done, so we all set. So next time we come here, come on, Aldo. All right, so next time we're gonna, she's gonna be against the wall, and we'll be able to, you know, upgrade our little spirit summons like the wolves, or like spirit summon. And so if you go down, there's some door. There's some stoneware, the key door. That's talisman that we laid it. We'll get back to it this later on. But there's a crossbow in this that they said I would suggest it if you know it's not necessary. So there's second door that has a talisman that has some sort of like ranged advantage type potential. We'll talk about that later on, but we can just ignore them. And over there, there's a mirror. You can change your appearance. You can go to the you can change the gender. The type A is the male. The type B is the female. So you can change anything, your hair, whatever. Switch voices, age around, and the face structures, and the body style, body type, appearance, hair, everything. And to make different looks. I'm gonna stay with where I'm at. So just keep it the way I look. So that's the Fia, Doctor, we got a free hug. So when she hugs you, I'm gonna get the health debuff, but that's okay. It will go away first time you die. And the Bodakians, the blessings, which it will increase your poise. So basically, anytime you want to get the buff, you come here to get a hug and you lose some health and you get a buff instead. Yeah, and the last thing is Gideon. He doesn't have much dialogue for now, just going to talk to her. Just burn the his dialogue. And this that room will open later where we get the boss weapons and spells and all this stuff. For now, that's going to cover everything at the round or whole table. And now if you've already gone and done farming, so this the blacksmiths can upgrade your weapons all the way. So that blacksmith, we're gonna go there. That is excellent time to get going. Similar to the last episode, to figure out what weapon you're gonna to fight with. And I'm gonna fight with this the bloodbound, but I need to level up. And he's 17 dex and 18 strength. But so far, I'm just gonna work with the morning star. For now. And when I hit those levels, I'm going to switch over and upgrade that weapon. And we're going to the height west. And we're gonna clear some stuff. It's over there. You shouldn't have any issues clearing through this stuff at this point of the game. Even though this is the our east, this is still considered the limb grave, which is a little early area. Just, you know, be a little careful and don't get overwhelmed. Pumpkinhead is probably the one thing to look out for over here. Pumpkinhead starts getting closer, then, you know, as I see him, it's better to get away from him. Yep, he's getting closer. I'm gonna lead him to fight with the other enemies, so I can continue. Actually, I don't have to fight everybody here, just for good for practice. And this little guy, you can lead them to them to fight with him. Yeah, this little guy, you can use them. And so while they're fighting, you're just gonna lead there. You just keep moving. So we're gonna need to get rid of this the one that fires the fireball guy. So this guy threw the bomb. I need to take care of it. Oh, just watch out for the rats. Just get clear the rats. And the one left. Yep. When you do the backstab, well, that's called like a critical animations. And but if you like kill like multiple the enemies, then you get the portion back, whatever that you used. And there's cookbook right there. I'm gonna go up there, all the way up. And there's item that we need to get here. Okay, it's right there. Now we're gonna backstab, but sometimes it's easier if you just single enemies. But the best backstab or the parry while you're in the animation, you have like a permanent like flame, so if you're in the middle of the backstabbing someone and does someone to drop like a giant and you cannot take the damage from it. So yeah, so I did summon this guy, you know. Just like the when we were taking care of the bosses. Yeah, I let them heal. I'm trying to do the like open for like backstabbing. I'm trying to go there. And watch out for that this is how this guy. I just circle around the back, there you go, almost. Yep, I got it. That's critical hit right there. Yep, this is what we got. This is what we're looking for. The that's what the Blood Slash is actually an extra for, you know, to have all your own. Yeah, we got the half medallions that is needed to get us into the late game area. And need to have two healths. Just grabbing that now and getting out of the way. Yeah, the main reason that we get here was the bloody slash. And I already got a cookbook. This last guy. All right, so that's gonna be it for this area. So we're gonna link to that the quest. So head to the third church. That's the church in the Mistwood where we got our physics. I remember that we're gonna be heading to that. Let me see. Yeah, to the area right there. So we're gonna head over and just tell the dude like things are cleared. Yeah, try to stay in the morning. And notice that the last time I picked it I died at the you know, where the doggy, the big doggy was. So I'm gonna pick that up quickly. So once you die, there is gonna be the mark, the where ruins drops, on the where you when you die at the spot, the area. So if you lose it, if you die again before you pick that up, you will lose the entire ruins that you get. So it's always good to, you know, to use it ahead of it. I'm just gonna pick that quickly. It's just right there, and then as soon as I pick that up, the ruins, I go back to the place. So mark right there at the campus, it shows where the ruins are dropped. You can either pull up a map or to find it out. So right there, the big dogs are. I thought that they're gonna chase me, but they did not. Which is good, and I'm gonna go back to the place. So now I'm gonna put it on this blessings. I'm gonna put on this the blessings and for the defense. I mean the stamina ones. Since we got it. Yeah, I prefer to have my health back, but we want to talk to her and do that at least once, because she has the quest that's actually tied to a secret ending. Not an ending, you get an additional trophy, anything like that, but still a secret ending, the worthless, I mean it's worth. So it's worth getting the first the hug. So you can see the buff on the top left when the hug is active. I forgot to equip it, the stamina one, so I'm gonna quickly add stamina. I was just thinking like, okay, I'm here. Yeah, the stamina that we got it earlier. Now you see that there's two stats, one for the with the stamina increase buff, and the other one is the health debuff. So I'm gonna talk to this guy. We'll get you the nice dagger. I just accept and you know, go. So we have gone through his dialogue. So now his request is pretty simple. He's gonna head back to the fort. Things are going to work. He goes. So he wants to go send. He's gonna say to go find another the Lord. At the point you can kill him and you can get yourself a free seed. I haven't found any more his requests yet. But if I figure it out, then I will try to let you guys know that before we try to kill him. But besides that, we're able to go. This is big place to surf around. So from here, let's go to the. I think we can get the cave done first. So Church of Ella. So these areas have tons of the caves. So this is where the. That we're gonna take the video to go over. So there's a lot of place that we can burn our way through a lot of these caves. The first one is just straight north from the church. So this is not daytime is good. There's tons of things to do on the map. The biggest thing right now is just to this early episode. Yeah, really just to give you an idea of the scope of the map, just how much there's so uncover and to discover. I'm just messing around these guys. Guys like, nah, let's keep going. Just kill this guy quickly and go. Get some runes. Alright. active to summon the roll, to summon the pole. So let's mix our the physics. We're gonna do, since we're about to start the combat doing content. So the physics, like I said, this is to make your own portions. Another, we picked up these two, so both are really nice. So with that one, we boost the max stamina, and then the other one is the enhanced charge attack, which I mentioned is the charge attack can knock down the blows, which will then open the enemy for the critical. So both of those are really nice early pickups. We have some, we're gonna get a little bit later, they're a much much better one. So soon we're gonna get some better ones, but right now keep leveling up my dexterity. That's a good one. Yeah, I need the dex, and the reason is for this, the remember that there might be the and there's a two-handed bonus. So we hit the 18 strings. We've already at the 15. So two-hand will be over there. So probably right now is getting my dex up to 17, so that I can use my bloodbound. So we are going to change the one flex over now. If you cast a build, you're just going to have to kind of feel out how many of you blue flask you want. I think maybe 4, 2, 3 ratio is usually pretty good. If you're a melee build, I would suggest having at least one. And the main reason for that being is that we can pop our, you know, the remaining of the FP to do the summon. I accidentally pull up the for the energy ones. Yeah. So we can use this the physics by clicking the opening the triangle and just hit the light. And after you do your summon, you're gonna sum FP back to your weapon art. Now there's some like wolves, there'll be wolves down there. The one is the most dangerous, and the other one is most the basic. See that was coming. I was trying to use the heavy attack. I was trying to focus with the light attack. I thought that there was a door. I should get this should be the distance for doing it so. Try to avoid it. Let's get back these wolves. I get this time. Yeah. Now I'm getting out that area. Pick it up. And I'll start to take them since they're coming one at a time. So good to go. Cleared. If I head to the boss area, I want to make sure I picked all the items here. Now we're gonna get into the let's talk about bit about the different types of attacks, and just the very there's just very ways that you can take out enemies in this game. So with the weapons, yeah, to this right before the boss, this is a little the campfire. We can see a lot of stuff. With this the heavy attack, that's heavy attack. We did a light attack, and that's R2. That's running a light attack, and that's running the heavy attack. Back and then back light attack, back heavy attack, roll, back stab, we just did it, and then the roll, the heavy and roll, rolling attack and roll, rolling to the light, rolling to heavy. That's a light and rolling to the and there's jump light and jump the heavy. So these attacks also may vary, depends on whether you have one hand or two handing weapons, but those are the basics. So anytime you're gonna use this new weapon, really feel for the what works well, so I can see that it does back and throws going forward. backstab, and then he's going to step into slam. I can see testing. I can actually charge as well as he could backstab and attack and get out the charged. And that's probably one of the most important things in these games. Yeah. Backstab and with light or heavy attack. Alright, so before we get to the fight. Alright, so now let's go back to fight the boss. So it's really important thing is just kind of like getting a feel for your weapons, knowing you know exactly what your weapon is capable of, what it is able, you know, to do. That will make things a lot easier. So as you just progress though. So anytime you cross the boss fog, usually you're gonna be able to get up to a summon. I'm just gonna dodge this guy, the boss, a little bit until he starts looking at the wolves. Not only on, your wolves are going to do the tons of damage. There's actually here to just to distract the target. So you can see what I'm doing. I'm gonna let the wolf distract, and then I was gonna into charge the heavy attack. So the heavy attack more damages, so I can knock him out and open for the critical attack. And the guy will have no way to get a chance to win. And just briefly distract the target, and then you're gonna be able to, you know, get in those really beefy attacks. If you're a caster, obviously you're gonna be able to sit back and cast a bunch. So that's, you know, what people say this is the most appreciable Souls game yet. So, you know, it's this great appreciable Souls game for the new players. I've seen a lot of people kind of like upset. So, but don't get me wrong, so there are very hard bosses. So this can easily compare to previous soul games in terms of the difficulties, but we do have a lot of things to make it more approachable this time around. So we can able to use the Ashes of War, which we'll get into that a little bit, to change things up. We're able to use a Spirit Summons, which the Spirit summons a huge game character. Just checking. I'm gonna go. Okay. Thinking. Oh, okay. So, never before in a soul game, being able to just summon wolves on demand that are going to distract the enemy to help you fight. So, there's a lot here. I can really help if you take the time to explore and get into this. So we're gonna get into a clear out to walk out this area. Just gonna going to the walk up to the guy, and especially if you do like the lower posture and with a target him and try to go behind him, and that will make it open for the critical attack. So that's what I'm gonna about to do it. That guy right there, the first enemy. You have to get really closer to do the critical attack. And this up to the nice sword. There's a guy with the horn. He's right there. He's coming. The one that I target him. So this is actually also the good area to test it out. So while you on the crouches, you can hold the circle, you can see, and then fast forward, kind of like do the critical attack, the one I just did it. And that's the main guy I was just targeting. Trying to hide it. Take him out. Guess he saw me. So I'm gonna take him out first. Yep, that's the main guy right there. So he sees me. So we're just gonna go through and basically kill everything here. Just gonna clear this out. As soon as you kill that one guy, the first, that has a horn. It's because he will summon summon everything that is in the zone and try to fight you. That can make things a bit tricky. I mean, even though the guy is coming at you, you can just, you know, the back out and do it. But I thought that there was no backing out places. I didn't notice that. And actually you can walk and get guys to call all the troops out and just kill one by one while you backing it up, attack and roll back out, or jump back up. Or if you use, you know, some enemies, they have like their own territory, so they will go back if you stay like far away from the specific zone area. So they'll just go back to their positions. So I'm back here. I'm gonna try to take care of it. Try to take care of these guys as quickly as possible. Start with this one again. One down. I'm just gonna get my runes back quickly. I don't know why it was there. I was not even there either. Just gonna try to take one by one. And if they, you know, if they're coming at you, just there's just a little army of the soldiers that can just test your spells against it. Oh, I really like this area for, you know, for testing purposes. So just wait for they attack you first and start to hit them. Okay, there's the main guy right there. He looked at me. So as soon as you turn away, he looks at me again. The other guy, he looks at me and when I go back, and that's how they react. So I'm gonna take out this main guy first. And summon. Looks like the way we took care of the boss. And then while the one is still focusing on it, this guy was focusing on this the wolves. I'm gonna go, you know, backstepping. At the same time when the base is open, and I'm gonna attack him, but yeah, wolves. They're pretty nice, pretty good to use it. So I'm gonna take care of this guy quickly. I believe there's a weapon, the box down there. Hey, that's the one. I'm just like thinking like how I'm gonna like, you know, proceed. Of course try to take care of every, you know, the people here, but you don't have to like kill everyone. You can just go kill the guy that the area that you wanna pick up the weapons. And like they look out for like a chest. And there's good weapons in the carrier. So they're not the decks. I'm not the only dexterous weapons. Well, yeah, I'm actually really excited to try that out on my own play through when I start playing the dex. So there's like a and there's the map if you have not been reached. Yeah, for that one, you can get it for the small runes. There's nothing, other than that, there's no other values. Okay, so we're gonna go down there. If we go, take care of this quickly. cleared. Oops, still there. Like last one in this area. Yeah, this is going to be the first very important ones. The first the redstone. Very important items. We're gonna talk about that just in seconds. Some more like the knights to beat them down. Well, we don't have to kill everything, everyone here. We're just gonna, because they are like, you know, already here. Let me check around. Blood all of the characters. And I believe there's a few more guards. In general, when it comes to combat in games like this and any Dark Souls game, watching the enemies is going to be your best, the best, you know, to the way that you just paying attention to the enemy's movement, and then countering after you know what they're gonna do. Now, another thing I haven't talked about until now is a parrying. When an enemy is gonna attack, but if you have a parry equipped like a shield, you can do that, knock the weapon away, and then going instantly open the enemy up for critical attack. Now parries are very strong. Don't get me wrong, their parries are absolutely devastating, especially in PvP. But it's something, but definitely something you're gonna want to practice. I'm gonna do this with this guy. So I'm gonna kill this one of them first. Trying to find out the spot that I can do parry this guy. I think he's the last one. I'm gonna lure him. It's open space, open world. That first failed. Second was not parry, just a block. So I wanna make sure this is parable. Nope, failed. Alright, energy. Now this is a parry. He's open. So you just near in, this is another parry. So when this happens, you just go near with him and then press the light attack, get close to him and click the light attack, and we'll do the critical attack. So I'm gonna go into the last one, the last pairing. After that, he's gonna do the quick attack, but he's gonna like do the heavy attack. So harsh portion. Okay, just blocked it. There you go, we'll take care of him. Yep, so he's good. Yeah, so that took like quite a bit. I never considered myself very good at parrying, but a small shield to make it a lot easier. Small shield, you're going to get a lot of more frames. You're gonna pay your parry up. So at this point, I'm gonna getting really explore. I have done a little bit kind of early combat explanations and grab a couple of key items and rest run over to the Grace. We're gonna really get started here. So I wanna to cover using the web blade and scaling and all the stuff before we really set up out into this world. And the farm that we talked about back in like in the start episode, now would be a good time to do that, to get some level upgrades into your weapons. So heading back to the Grace. Let's talk about the Ashes of War, because now we have access to the first redstone. So the Ashes of War allow you to do is to change the unique ability on your weapon. So right now the Morning Stars, let's kick it, and it's picked up, and we picked up the Ground Slam, Jump, and and stomp and determinations. We have like a sacred blade, and we have a poisonous mist. So this will basically give gives your weapon special techniques. So if I have since I have like a shield, if I hit like the L2, then it does the parrying. So let me try with this. So hit with hit with L2 is pairing right there. It's going to be better, but if I have a shield without with no skill, or I'm handling with my weapon, or I have nothing in my hands, I'm going to get the special ability, which is the kick. I'm doing the kick. So if I go instead and switch up to the the one that we got it earlier, which is a secret blade. I put it on. So now that the blade I did it on the ground. Hit it on the air, then now it's enchanted with the holy. So you'll notice that here it says the 263 on the tech power, and if I equip it, put it back to the then you can see go down to 177. So what it's doing is giving me the buff that will deal holy damage on this addition to the raid that's just out. And besides that, when we select that, you can change the scaling. So if you keep standard with the damage, it's going to be 118 plus 17. So the base damage is the weapon is getting with the standard scaling, and the plus 17 is the scale damage. So I'm getting from the attribute scaling D&D tricks and dexterity. Think of anybody like getting 118 damage with this weapon or standard, but the more strength, more dex you have, the more the secondary number goes up. Now if you make a secret instead, the new baseline damage is going to be 84 physical and 84 holy. Before the attribute scaling, you can see the strengths go down to E, dex going down to E, and then face goes up to D. So here I have more damage overall, because as opposed to the 118, I'm just getting this 80 I'm getting 84 because of splinter damages, but my scaling goes down. So instead of getting plus 18, I'm going to only gain 2 and 5. This is a really great thing, so you can customize weapons, really match your playstyle. For example, if I go here, because then I can see the scaling, I can go the poisonous mist. That's the secret. So that's a poisonous mist. So doing it there, I'm going to have the access to for both poison buildup and blood buildup. Because this already has a blood loss build up at 50, that's going to go drop down to 45, and I'm going to get some poison build up to 66. So other things that's going to go still keep up the blood loss build up, or you could effectively have the blood loss and the frostbite, or blood loss and poison. So really cool that you kind of mix and match with to this, and later on as we get more and more the web blades, we'll have more options available. So I can do this, be able to make a standard poison, like heavy king quality, a bunch of different things. So for stats, scaling in particular, we have a couple tiers. The highest is the rated, and then after the S rated, there's A, B, C, D, E. If it's if you get E, you're getting basically like nothing out of it. A lot of weapons you find is going to have very low attribute scaling early on. I'm not gonna see those big values until you level it up. And I think I do have a really good example of it. Yep, those are levels right there. So let me explain about the really good example of this. The medial right staff. Yeah, it's in the weapon type. So this thing, you cannot level up, but stats that you can scaling and LS. So a lot of people see this and they're gonna say, oh man, it's scaling, this high class is every other step. This step I'm seeing like only like a C or D, but then because that stats can level up. So when you level up other steps, you probably also see you will see much higher damage out of it. So while we're talking about the stats, let's brief look at something what I want to point out here. And this is my caster Fox out there, that there's a scaling out here. First, there's a scaling, the source of scaling, well, in King. So scaling data value is going to determine how strong your spells are. When it comes to your spells, in particular the damage formula, actually takes a look at what your basically all the damage you're going to do is cracker off the catalyst you're using. That's a step with encampment sealed. And the catalyst is going to have its things determined based on what the scaling of it is. So if this is S scaling, if you look at your intelligence and use it determine to source scaling, and then that number is what is going to determine how hard you spell it. But because of that, right now my strength build, I don't have the 18 the phase, because I don't have the 18 phase. The source scaling is 60, which is very very low. So keep that in mind anytime you're looking at new weapons and potentially mixing things up. If you don't meet this the stat requirements, you're not gonna able to do the see the true damage. Now, the one the alternative, this is when it comes too handy. So let me see if I have anything that that do meets the strengths with the two hands. So this one, I don't have the 16 strengths. So I hand right there right now, so I cannot. You know, if I go C, you can see the right-handed arm and power 81. If I two-handed my mace and I go and look, and because my character is absolutely into the handling, and I can truly I can actually see the true damage. So I'll be able to do 163 with this. If I was two-handed, it's like 178 with my secret. With the secret Morning Star, and the thing was also the secret. I'll be more of an the great comparison. But it is how it all the runs down. So at this point, we have a lot to do. We'll be taking the loop and basically just going around hitting everything that we can in all of the Limb's Grave. So this is gonna be the next episode. So before we really starting on the Limb Grave, at this point we've kind of like gone through the basics of combat and the movements of the animation and tactics and how to attack with 3D weapons and at the base camp. We got your web blade. And so what I want you to do now is to pick up the starter weapon and try out, see how it goes and see what you like and figure out what you feel. Good at what you like to do. As you know, once you pick up the weapon, so we're gonna head back to the round table. Now we're gonna upgrade it with as much as we have available. So if you're following the quality build, you should be able to get up to the +3. If you're doing the regular weapons, just doing the this will get you the up to 4. Now pick your weapons and use a little the method to get enough souls to make sure you can upgrade it. And then from the next episode, we're gonna start from here. We're gonna take a big loop around the entire grave and hit a lot of stuff.